TU Dresden has really good reputation in communication technology. And also in recent years, Dresden became the center of robotics in Germany. I expect the robots can assist the human more. And I also want to tell people, please don't be scared. Robots will never replace us. Robots will just be our good assistant. My name is Jiajing Zhang. I'm a junior PhD researcher at CITI. CITI stands for Center for Tactile Internet with Human in the Loop. And our central vision is to enable the human to interact in quasi-real time with the cyber-physical systems, so-called CPS, over the intelligent wide area communication networks. In CITI, we have multiple research rooms, and I'm located in K2 room, which is intelligent networks. I joined the CITI in October 2019. And this is my third year. I'm a junior PhD researcher here, and so of course, most of the job is to do some research. And currently my topic is about resource allocation. Maybe I can give you one simple example. You like to go shopping and buy a lot of clothes and shoes, but you only have one or two closets. How can you sort of your things and store everything in a smart and nicely way? This is very similar to my topic in communication networks because we also have limited storage. So how can I allocate the resource in order to fulfill the exponentially increasing demand from the end users? Because some users want to have low latency, some users want to have high data rate, and the resource is limited here. And besides doing research, I'm also supporting for some demos. I really cherish this opportunity because I'm not only learning something for myself, but I'm also spreading knowledge to the whole society. This demo is called TreePen. It was developed by another startup, Vandenbots. And we have shown this demo to the pupils in school and also to the public on some events and fairs because we want to show the insight of possibilities, how to use tactile internet. This is called a TreePen. And this is working like a computer mouse for our robot. For instance, here, I can draw any shape to tell the robot, please follow what exactly I just did. Meanwhile, this pen is actually tracing my movement all the time. Now you can see this robot actually learned exactly what I just taught him to do. Maybe you have noticed before that I didn't do any programming. I just used this TreePen to do something and the robot learned automatically. Well, I hope you can recognize this funky shape. Sorry, I'm not a good painter. It only takes a few seconds to record and demonstrate a new robot movement. It doesn't require people to have the knowledge of programming. Therefore, anyone, even the pupils in school and the workers in the factory, they don't need to learn programming. In the future, we can use this easily in the industry. It can save a lot of time and cost. For instance, in industry, this can be a welding machine, and the workers just need to teach the robot where exactly and how exactly the welding should take place. And then all the robots can just assist the workers to finish this process. And one of the major use cases is Internet of Skills. Here we built up a piano demo. What we want to do here is to trace the expert skills from someone and then transfer this skill to someone else from far distance. We have already shown this in Sound and Science event, and in May we will also show it again in another benefit concert. Someone like the piano teacher is putting on the gloves and also a suit. Here there are some sensors. Here and here. So altogether, these sensors can sense the movement of our body, of hands, and these motions will be captured and stored. Later will be transferred via the tactile internet to, for instance, to a student somewhere else. And then the student will feel the motion and learn directly from the teacher. Right now, we are at the beginning of the new era of using robots to assist our work in daily life. And I'm very happy to witness such a transition. Some of my colleagues are using robot to play chess, and also we can just use robot to help us do some monotonous work. You can imagine such a simple work can be done by a robot in the future. For instance, there is some extreme environment, like some warehouse with extreme low temperature, and some devices are broken. Human, we cannot go there. So we can send a robot to repair these broken devices. Therefore, yeah, I feel very excited to work with robots. My favorite aspect is a huge variety of challenges we are facing every day. And especially we have colleagues from all different fields and we can help each other to conquer this challenge. For instance, for us, the communication engineers, we know our task is to guarantee the data can be delivered in quasi-real time. But what exactly is quasi-real time? How to define this quasi-real time? And then we have some colleagues from psychology. They are doing some experiment to find out how many milliseconds human cannot sense the difference. And then this is a very important result for us. Meanwhile, we can also offer some engineering skills. For instance, we offer like to use machine learning to predict the motion of humans. And this is also something very interesting for psychology people. And I really like this working environment. I'm also responsible for teaching and supervision. For instance, with another colleague from the TP3 room, we supervise students together. First of all, I expect robots in the future to be more intelligent, to be smarter, because right now I feel like we are teaching a robot what to do. But in the future, we hope the robot can learn and improve by itself. And also we are expecting to build the robot which can build the way for us instead of standing in the way of human. Currently, the robot can only finish one task. And since the robots are getting smarter and smarter, we expect robots can handle multiple tasks at the same time. For instance, right now at home, you have the robot vacuum cleaning. And in the future, maybe we can have smarter robot which can not only cleaning the floor, but also helping you wash dishes, maybe. So thanks for being with me today. I hope you like my day at City. If you would like to see the previous video of Arbeit Meet, please click here. And if you would like to see more videos about TU Dresden, please click here. Don't forget to ring the bell and subscribe our channel. Thank you.